Hello everyone, my name is Vasco Elbrecht, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to extract stream data, so streams here, from Google Maps to make your own little map which you can use in your publications. You can of course use free software to generate maps like QGIS, but you need for this good shapefiles. So here we see our streams, and in this file here we don't have all the small contributing streams to this main stream reach. If you take a look at Google Maps, however, we can see that in this area we have here the main stream, there are a lot of small tiny streams. So I kind of want to have this map here because it's much more detailed. So I'm going to show you how this can be done quite easily with Illustrator or Photoshop. Let's get rid of this navigation point here. And we start by taking a screenshot. So on a Mac, you can do this by pressing Command, Shift, and 4. We're going to select the area where we want to make a screenshot. So we select the whole stream reach we have here, which is important for our study. I also take care to include the little measuring bar, the little scale bar here, to have the right scale, which you can add later to the figure. Now we have taken a screenshot, you can see this here, and I'm going to copy this file, so we duplicate this. We're going to rename our files here, we call this one Stream Gray, because we're going to convert this into black and white, and this one we call Stream Color. Now we need Illustrator and Photoshop. I have versions from 2014, so any newer version should work as well. In Photoshop, we're going to import our stream gray picture. And now we want to convert this into grayscale, so that our stream here, which is blue, is black and all the other lines are fading away. We can do this under Image, Adjustment, Black and White. This will convert our picture to black and white, and we can play around with those levers here, and we're going to try and make everything else which is not a stream disappear. So of course the stream is blue, so we put up the blues onto maximum, and you already see it appears quite well, and we can pull everything else down. So this makes all the street names and streets and forests disappear. We still have the street name here, so let's see if we can get rid of this as well. Yeah, maybe not, but we can delete this later. So if we zoom out now, you see there are still some other things going on, but let's try to keep it like this and not worry too much about those details right now. So we're going to save this file here. Just go on save. And we're going to import this into Illustrator. So drag and drop it into here. And if we select this file now, we can see here a menu appears, which is called Image Trace. We click on this one, and this can be used to convert a picture into line art, basically vector lines, which is what Illustrator is using. If we take a look at this, this didn't do a too good of a job, so we can go on the options panel here, and in preset we're going to select sketched art. This will make sure that the lines here are treated more as lines and not as shapes, because a river of course is a line. We can take a look at advanced. And here we have to go on create strokes and uncheck create fills. So this actually will convert our streams into lines. So a stream is a single line and not a shape which is filled black. This actually looks quite nice already. You can see that most other elements on this map disappeared. You can play around with those parameters a bit more if you want to. But for now, I think this is good enough. I'm going to close this again and click on expand. This converts the image now into lines, basically the lines which Illustrator is working with. If we click on this and go on ungroup, we could go ahead now and take a look at the sections where we had streets running through the river. And using the pen tool, we can actually go ahead and reconnect those sections again so that they look a bit nicer. If you click and drag, you can also get a little bit round shapes into this one as well. So you can go around and repair your streams where a street basically did one over your streams. I'm not going to do this for all the stream sections here, just showing you how this can be basically cleaned up. You can also go ahead and delete some unwanted artifacts which are in here. But before you do that, it might be a good idea to actually import the original picture we had behind this stream network. So let's create a new layer, and we put this layer below the layer where the stream is on. And let's import our stream in color. Let's align those again. So we can briefly group this by pressing Command G. And if we select both of those, we can go to the line option here and click those two, which basically perfectly aligns your stream with everything else in the background. We can then lock this layer, and this one can be ungrouped again. Let's just pretend we have cleaned up this complete stream. Let's also make sure that the color of the stream is actually blue. So if you don't see any color in here, this is because we directly imported this. You can put this onto a new empty spread, or we can also just go here and select the color we want. So let's try with nice blue. Of course, you want to have the lines here selected, and probably this blue will be good enough. Of course, depends on your map if you want to have it blue or black. We can also go ahead and change the line thickness. So if we select all of those lines again, we can increase the thickness of the stroke. You can even go ahead and select individual sections of the stream, so you would have to select all of the sections of this main stream reach, for example, and you can increase this, for example, by, let's say, 6. We see here that the tracing did apply to a side stream. In a case like this, we can select this and select in here the scissors tool, and this allows you to cut your stream section wherever you want. So let's select this again, and we can use the eyedropper tool to copy the thickness of a smaller stream. You would, of course, want to connect all of those different reaches, but I'm not going to do this in this demonstration. Also, the really nice thing is, because those here, those stream reaches, are line art, this actually means that we could divide those into different sections, like this, and actually apply some other coloring on them. So for example, if we say we want to indicate stream water quality, we could do something like this, where the stream water quality gets worse over time. And of course, you can add sample points and so on to your stream. So this is the basic stream structure that you could also make with any GIS program, but this is kind of simple and very straightforward to do for anybody who has Illustrator and Photoshop. Let's maybe for now get rid of this background layer. We do one last thing, and this is we want to copy the scale bar. So we're going to hide this layer for now. We're going to create a new layer, and then we're just going to take the square here, and we're going to copy this scale bar. Let's give it a black color. Like this, and we're going to add the text 500 meters, which is our scale. So this is quite nice, because now we can also move this a bit more onto our map, and we can get rid of the background picture. So we're just going to hide it with this layer. We get back our stream layer and lock our scale. Let's just say I'm interested in this section of the stream. I'm just going to go to this layer where the stream is in, and I'm drawing a rectangle. So this will be the section of the stream we are interested in. And I'm going to copy this rectangle. So I press the Alt key and shift this to the side, which does copy it. Let's move it a bit further to the side. And then we select all of this and we go right click, create clipping mask. This will basically cut out our section where this rectangle was above. And then to align both, we select both again and align them using the vertical align tools here. Then we just have to switch the colors and we got ourselves a nice border around our map. Let's maybe move this in the center. We can also then take our scale bar, which is always good to include on maps. Let's center both of them a bit more and we add this to the map as well. By the way, if you are not annoyed by those green guides which are always appearing, you can turn those off under View, Smart Guides, just in case you have them activated. Let's also try to get a nice north arrow in here as well. So I always do this with a triangle and I press the down key to reduce the number of corners in the star, and now I press the shift key to center it. Then I'm going to take the selection tool here and I move this point up a bit. Let's squeeze this arrow together a bit more. We put it into here and then we just write a big N for north. We change the color to white. And place it into here. So here we have our not very cleaned up map, but you can see in principle how you can extract streams from Google Maps in just a few minutes. If you want to save this thing, you can go on Save As, maybe put it on your desktop, and we save this one as an Illustrator file. You can also export this, for example, as a PNG or as a PDF if you go on to Save as Copy and we select in here PDF. So this is really useful for printing or for publications where you want to have it in a good quality. Let's go on Save. And in just a few minutes, we have here our final stream. And we can take also a look at Google Maps again. How those two are comparing. All right, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Let me know if you have any questions on Twitter.